Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Avernum 4, where we are obviously, of course, still in these tunnels, which will keep us busy until the sun dies and everything goes black. Okay, first of all, we have a soundtrack. First of many, I'm sure. And, well, oh wow, nice. Nice, good start. Very good start. Did not take damage from that one. We're back to the big cave, where we hopefully took out most of its evil inhabitants, but there is at least one regular Kytrak still left. Should have no trouble taking that one out by letting just coming here. Fire, almost killing it. Okay, almost. There we go. All right. Oh no, submission fungi. Those things suck. Actually, they spit, but you know. Details. Can't reach from there, huh? But from there you can. They're just way too tanky. Are there more of them? I feel like there probably are. Gonna not rush in. Oh, there is a Kytrak coming also. Great. Yeah, Dirk is stunned. Could try and do is these. Okay, they're both running low on spell points. Really hard. I guess we'll deal with this thing first. Okay, thanks for not getting parried. Oh, sweet! Oh, level ups. I didn't even check. Yeah, but they were both really close. Honestly, I did not expect them to be close to the next level up, but this is obviously way better. Wait, he's at 5, which I can't do much with. I could increase magery, but no, I actually need more mage spells and priest spells, respectively, because we're definitely now slowly but surely getting these higher level spells that we currently cannot even use. So definitely have to make that a priority. Can you reach from there? You can. Very good. Kill it, please, with a good hit. No. Can you hit it at all? Not sure why the fungus didn't do anything. There's her level up. Very good. Okay. Switch back to the correct weapon. And well, I was half joking earlier, but we know that this is not the last map either. I think there is one that we know of to the north and west of here, of this one, if I'm not mistaken. And honestly, I would at this point not be surprised to find another two maps to the south and west of here. In fact, is it actually? I can't believe it. Wait, Reptile Island? Excuse me? There is an island here. We actually went under the sea, or not the sea, but under the lake, to this island. Okay, well that's interesting. I was not expecting that at all. That being said, there's a good chance. What is this? Okay, just someone. How heavy is this? Actually, a little bit too heavy, but for now it's still fine. Yeah, I'm not gonna continue in this direction for now. First of all, because I want to finish off this map, and then of course the other one that we already saw a little bit of. But primarily because I want to go to Fort Drenlon first and see if maybe there's a quest to deal with this, with the island. Two more. Okay, you know what? Let's go around this way and attack them one by one because they're bad enough as it is. Also, I guess I didn't renew the buffs on everyone. That's why they ran out. So let's fix that real quick. Increase her damage because, well, it might actually make the difference at some point. Is it the fungus? That sauce? I mean, I guess it did see us, so that makes sense. Also, the fungus cannot reach us from here, huh? Can it not? Is that so? Oh. I guess that is so. Nope, never mind. Now, I guess it's a matter of the AI being fixated on one particular party member. And so long as that party member is not in range, and it's an immobile enemy like this, it's actually not going to attack rather than change its priority. Which, you know, another great example for the AI being stupid in my favor. Okay, next up. Okay, this one is definitely gonna be able to reach all of us, unless... Well, wait. If I stand there, no, it's probably gonna... Yeah, okay. I expected as much. But that being said... I don't know, it's gonna wanna attack the last person that attacked it, right? Or maybe not. I guess. In this case, it wanted to attack either Mike or Dirk, and couldn't reach them. Weird. Weird, but useful. Okay, everyone's fully healed. Everyone's buffed with long-term buffs. Let's see if we actually got another map to the west of here. It kind of looks like this is gonna continue. Being such a major path, there is an egg here. Save. I'm not sure when I last saved, but better safe than sorry. There's another fungus. Please kill it, please kill it. Well, not quite. It's a plated one, too. Yep, it's gonna attack twice. There is another one. Let's do this. They're both stunned. Fungus was too far away. But, okay. There's no hurry. We can do this. Reducing the damage he takes to only 13. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay. This was a gamble, because they definitely are want to parry. I should have used the time to... buff or do something useful. Okay. Or we could kind of ensure that we kill it this turn. Well, actually, we can completely ensure it this way. No, again, it's not completely ensured at all. And then the fungus seizes the opportunity. Can't really blame it for that. Okay, we'll do this. We'll heal you. Can't shoot it from here? No, maybe from here. Yes, you actually can. How convenient. Well, you just wait there. Okay. Wow, that was 42 damage. And a stun, of course. I mean, let's try this again. Okay, good. Worked. I'm going to... Oh, this is a tough call. I'm gonna heal first. I was thinking about... Oh, no. He's going to only attack Dirk now. That's bad, actually. Why don't you stand there, protect him that way? And you can buff yourself? Haste yourself? Dirk should be safe for now from the fungus. Gonna buff our defense. Actually, the fungus is gonna shoot after his turn, though. Oh man, this is... Okay, this should be fine. It's fully healed, actually. That's not fine. But, that being said... The Kytrek is probably gonna wake up anytime now, and we should be able to kill this thing at least. Please just walk away to relative safety. There is another fungus. Are you kidding me? Is that in range? Is it going to attack us? I feel like it probably is. You what now? I did not mean to do that, actually. That's okay. Let's once again, we're gonna... Oh, actually, with haste, this is pretty much guaranteed. There we go. Okay. Good, good. You just wait there. There's no rush. Man, these fungi are my absolute nemesis. I'm gonna have nightmares of these things. Two of them, huh? Almost... Well, theoretically, this one is a little bit closer, so we could try to outrange this one just ever so slightly. I guess that's what I'm gonna do. What I'm gonna have to do. That being said, we can reach it from here. I'm pretty sure that one's too far away. This one probably is not. Also, I never hasted her. We do have the protection buff. Now we have the attack buff. You need to get healed before I'll allow you to do anything. You'll stand there and hopefully the fungus is going to be confused. Yep, okay, good. Plan worked. You're going to actually haste her. It's gonna starting to be a little bit tough to keep track of who's buffed. You can actually do this and deal some range damage. There you go. And you have to start healing. Okay. Right, you can attack twice. You're gonna stand there again. Ha! Okay. Nice. Yeah, you heal everyone to full, and you'll finish up this fungus. Nice. Alright, that's the trick. That is the trick. Take one extra step, shoot that fungus. You stand there, the fungus is confused, because it can't reach the one that actually wants to attack. Alright. You know, for good measure... Yeah, can't reach from there. Please tell me that that was all of them. I don't believe it for a second, but it is nice to imagine. Oh, that's the egg. Okay. Oh, right, we're still hasted. But it was not enough. We're still gonna get attacked. Okay, well. A small price to pay. Can I actually... do it twice in a row. Okay, and yes, the map of course does connect. Of course it does. Okay, save the game again. I might be missing items, but then again, fungi and chitrax don't really drop things other than chitrax claws. Oh, okay. The tunnels ahead are very noisy. You hear the characteristic scuttling and hissing noises of the chitrax, but magnified many times. Oh no. You have stumbled upon a particularly dense nest of the nasty little insectoid creatures. Their discarded husks and broken eggs, egg casings are on the floor all around you. Looking closer, you note that some of the shed skins look very old and cracked. This must be one of the first chitrax infestations in this area, if not the first. Okay. Got the hive tender chitrax. Right, not just the egg tender, but the hive tender itself. Maybe, quite literally, the mother of all chitrax. We're gonna start by hasting you, okay. So you can haste two people next turn. That's a smart thing to do. I don't always act on it, even though I know that it is a smart thing. Wow, this thing! Summons a shower of acid? Did it? I didn't see the animation, and it didn't seem to affect any of us, but, you know. I'm okay with that. I should have cast... Daze, actually. This thing is gonna... Something bad is going to happen. And... I didn't even try to stop it. The thing is... Never mind, that hive tender is surprisingly... Ooh, ouch. Surprisingly harmless. Or rather, it died surprisingly fast, is what I meant to say. Okay, she's hasted, so in theory she should be able to cure him twice and we should survive. Okay, fine. Then heal twice. Okay, that... I was expecting that to go a lot less smoothly. Not gonna lie. And we get... nothing. Okay, so that was maybe just the first of many hive tenders. Maybe it's not so much a mini-boss as the egg tender was, or... was it even called egg tender? Egg something, I don't know. Oh, right. Still hasted. Definitely should make use of that fact. As best I can. You know what? So long as I don't have to fight another fungus, I'm okay with it. I'm okay with more Kytrax. What? Too far away? Really? Yeah, and I probably should have hasted my archer, shouldn't I? Okay. In fact, why don't I do so right now? Man, I'm being really wasteful with my spell points. We might be okay. This is a relatively wide open cave, which is certainly helpful in certain ways. Is that a hive tender? It is. Okay. So quite obviously it's not a unique enemy. Also surprisingly not particularly tough. I guess we haven't really seen it attack. It did summon or try to summon a shower of acid at some point, so I guess that's pretty nasty if that actually works. I wonder. Maybe this is far enough away? Nope. Still gets an attack off. Worth a shot, I suppose. Okay, you can cure him right away. You can shoot twice, sealing the deal. Very good, very good. Oh, got a red one. That might be a special kind of like. You can't shoot from there, can you? Oh, you can. Oh yeah, I guess. You got a line of sight there. Okay. Attack the archer, understandably. Please kill it, please kill it. Okay, thanks. What are you? Frenzied Kytrek, that does not sound great. They're both stunned for the moment. Okay. That means we prepare properly. Haste. Attack buff. Wait, wait. Haste. Both of the guys. And we start attacking this thing. Oh yeah, this is definitely the boss. Please, some good damage. Please, a good hit. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. That was very much needed. We burn this thing. Okay. Nice. Yeah, we don't need the Kytrek Claw. Well, judging by the layout of this map, there are probably more than one of those frenzied Kytreks. Yep. Also judging by the fact that we just found the second one. These things are tough customers. We'll wait here, okay. I mean, you're gonna wait. We should be fine. One attack should be enough here. Okay. There's a... the Kytrek Queen? You are not a Kytrek. I'm sorry. Save the game. Is our haste gonna last? Maybe. The chamber ahead is brightly lit. There are two large natural crystal spires in here, putting off a constant radiance of natural magical energy. Your skin tingles where the light strikes it. There is a creature between the two spires. It is a huge pulsing monstrosity, dripping long rivulets of acid from its pores. Ew. There are several large vents in its sides. As you watch in disgust, chitrag eggs slowly slide out of them. As soon as they are out of the creature, they start to shake and crack, the bugs inside already fighting to get free. This must be the source of the infestation. The beginning of the invasion of chitrags that have plagued the Eastern Gallery. And the reason why I was on the brink of returning as soon as I entered this cave. I mean, I don't really mind solving quests before I officially got them. But it somehow doesn't feel right. I don't know. There's something... I guess there is its own sense of satisfaction in, you know, telling the quest giver, oh, that, I've already done that. Give me my reward right now. But it's also, in another way, satisfying to do it the proper way. I don't know. You know? Not really sure what I'm even trying to say. I guess, either way, the result is the same. And since I'm here, I might as well take care of the problem right away, if I can. And it looks like I might be able to. I mean, I guess the main strength of the Chitrag Queen is probably going to be that it's constantly going to keep summoning more Chitrags. And so long as I can take them out. Okay. Queen is somewhat tanky, not surprising. Oh, summoning plated ones, are we? Okay, I'm gonna haste her. She actually needs to rebuff. And the haste is probably going to run out on the rest of the party as well. Oh, we actually... the Chitrag Queen stumbles back, stunned. Okay. Fine by me. Fine by me. Rebuff attack power. And wait, why did she only get a single turn? I just hasted her. No, seriously. Why did she not get a second turn? Okay. This game is weird. I don't know. Sometimes it does not make a lot of sense. You know what? Run forth. Boldly. Maybe too boldly. That one did not get stunned. Okay, haste is still going on everyone. You know what? I'm gonna do it again. Okay. Since there was a good chance that I was going to stun this last one. There's yet another one. You know, I had this slight worry in the back of my head that there might be things hiding in the shadowy corners, but I was not actually expecting two plated chitrags right there. That was maybe a mistake. Let's see here. In theory... Huh. She's hasted and she only has 7 AP. She's not encumbered. Why is that? What is going on? Oh, never mind. She had 12. I already cast a spell this time. That does not explain what happened last turn. I just had forgotten that I already acted. Now that being said, we could take out the one that's right next to Dirk because he'll be able to attack it. I would like to get to take these out, but if I attack this one once, I'll have to rely on Dirk shooting this twice and killing it, and I'm not sure that's gonna happen. But if I do this... Oh wow, that's more damage than I expected. These aren't plated. These are dormant. Dormant? I'm not sure what to make of that, necessarily. Also, Dirk only got one attack, despite being hasted. Mike has 10 action points. Yep. As he's supposed to. Did I mention that I sometimes don't really understand what this game is all about? Or what's going on in it? That's fine. there. This time he got two attacks. And Mike only got one, but his haste actually did run out, apparently. So, at least that makes sense. It's unfortunate, but it makes sense. I can't fix it, at least. Okay. Sure. Why don't you heal him as well? Kill the thing, and I guess deal more damage to the queen? Okay, attacking her. Poisons. Or rather, inflicts acid, which sucks, but that's how it is. Okay. Definitely getting there. I'm tempted to just deal damage, but I would, if at all possible, I would like to keep Dirk alive, Mike alive through all of this. Nice. Thanks for that crit. That was very nicely done. Okay, good. We can now slowly start moving ahead. Surprisingly, everyone else is still hasted, including Mike himself. Not Mike. Mario himself. I might have called Mario Mike in the past as well, now that I think about it. Who knows? Not important. Yeah, he hasted himself first, right? Or maybe not. Anyway, it only ran out once on Mike, though. I guess there's a certain variability. There has always been. You deal the final blow, indeed. The huge green tower of goo topples over on one side. You step back as acidic blood oozes from the wounds you have inflicted. With the queen gone, the soldiers of the Eastern Gallery finally have the chance to exterminate the Kytrax, at least temporarily. Kytrax are as tenacious and resilient as the goblins. Once gone, they will be back. Well, yeah, I guess, but, you know, this does certainly feel like an important victory. And I like it a lot. Okay, can we lure this thing out? No. Oh, it's a dormant one, again. Another dormant one. Wait. Okay, now it's coming. Hmm. Yeah, really not sure what dormant means in this case. Well, this is bad. Why do you keep doing this to me, game? Yeah, we're hasted, but what's the point? I mean, okay, we can at least do this. This could have gone very poorly if we hadn't been very lucky. Okay, you stand there. Attack the thing. Did not get stopped. And we did actually manage to kill the one. Okay. Phew! Kill it with ice in this case. Okay. You cure yourself. Not sure why a single attack was enough to so deeply poison you, but okay. Yeah, I did see those eggs there, and I did not act accordingly. I would have paid the price for my own stupidity, but thankfully we were saved by mostly luck, to be fair. And of course, the death of the queen does not mean that any of the already existing Kytrax here have disappeared. Mana is not looking great. In fact, so much so that they're both basically empty. Okay, only one attack though. Maybe because it was partially stunned. Oh no. This is actually really bad. Okay, drink a potion and cure. And you can also drink a potion, I suppose. At least the long-term buffs should last for a while longer because I renewed them relatively recently. So that's good. There's another one of these. Wow. And another plated Kydrak as well. Let's focus on this one. Wait there. Okay. Okay. Awesome. That worked on all of them. Good. You guys wait. You buff yourself. I buff protection. Now I buff attack. You wait one more turn. You buff the guys. You cure him. And I guess we start. In theory, we should be able to take out a plated Kydrak. Yes, like this. Okay, and then we can start on the next one. I'm tempted to start on this one as well. I shouldn't. Definitely should not. Instead, I'm going to haste her for good measure. She can then heal a little bit and. Okay. No, it woke up. I didn't realize it was already awake. Or I would have attacked, of course. Should still be fine. Because we can do this. Cure twice. Okay. Oh no. Okay. That could have been bad if Mike had missed that attack or had been parried. Unfortunately, exiting combat put us further forward than I planned, but it's still okay. You know what? Screw this. Chainmail's way too heavy. I'd rather pick up more crystals. They'll end up being a lot more valuable. Weighing a lot less. Pod speed potion. Actually, yeah, why don't you take one of those? Didn't even use any resources, actually, using during that queen fight. Oh, there are lots more eggs here. Okay. As expected. Unfortunately, our buffs ran out in the meantime. And I can't really afford renewing all the buffs for each one of these fights. Should play it safe in terms of making sure that this thing dies. Again, one parry or miss here would be potentially very, very deadly. There's another egg here. Okay, this is the central chamber. But it doesn't look like there's necessarily any enemies in there. That said, there's probably still quite a few left. Probably including another frenzied Kydrak or two. Okay. Slowly but surely, we'll clear this place out. Yeah, it sure looks like central chamber does not have any enemies. No special message as I approach this. Oh, there's a corpse. So I approach this hole. Surprisingly. Just a javelin. Ooh, steel breastplate. Worth 700? Oh, indeed. And a bronze halberd. 6 to 24. Yeah, okay. What's so good about this? Nothing, I guess. Hmm. Yeah, and it doesn't seem like halberds have the cleaving extra effect that they will have in the remakes, so no reason to take this. It looks special, and I'm pretty sure it's the first halberd that I've seen, but since it's only bronze, it's not worth it, I guess. Can you take this? No, absolutely not. That being said, 70 out of 66 might still allow you to act in combat. So I'm definitely gonna take that with me. Obviously very valuable. Yep. The usual. You kind of have to heal him? I guess curing would have worked as well. By reducing the damage he took. So much more. He's still poisoned up. How much? How long is it gonna take to run out? Too long, apparently. Do I have to? I mean, I guess not technically, but it won't feel right to leave any of these unhatched eggs just lying around like that. So I guess while we're at it, I'm gonna be thorough. I suppose I could... I probably should. Do this. We can actually... I mean, that's not gonna help as much. In fact... Okay, well. Oh well. At least he takes reduced damage, so... I guess it worked... a little bit. What I really wanted to do was buff attack, so that we might actually maybe kill the thing in one round. And I know that, yeah, I saw at least two more eggs this way. And definitely more adult Kytrax as well, maybe? Or not. Okay. But surely, yeah, here we go. It's a plated one. Plated? Plated one as well. Even though it looks kind of bright in this environment. And there's another hive tender. Hello. Welp. Oh, what? Acid rain and the double attack? Sorry, sir. I think that's illegal. Please kill it? Okay. Please don't die? Okay. Play it absolutely safe. Retreat all the way here before exiting combat, so that we don't see any... that we don't have any unpleasant surprises by just being put automatically one tile further ahead and maybe alerting more enemies that way. Belt? No. Gold necklace? Yes. Of course. But we're getting there. Most of the way done at this point. Okay. You'll wait and... yeah, hopefully... okay, good. Only acted once. Good, good. And one more plated Kytrax. For good measure. It's gonna attack once. Yep. Cure once. Please don't miss. Thank you. Save the game. This might very well be the last Kytrax in this cave. Okay, thanks for missing. Much appreciated. You know what? There. Have one of those. Nope. There is one more. Alright. Not really sure where it was trying to go. If it wanted to attack Dark, it could have from here. Hmm. Yeah. Her attack spell is so expensive, but you know, at this point, I really just want to make sure that nothing catastrophic happens before I'm done here. Well, that said, there is three more. There are three more eggs, and I want to deal with them. At least for those, I can prepare properly. Okay, save the game. Haste him, and that should already be enough. But just for good measure, I'm going to increase attack power as well. Nope, don't click on yourself, you idiot. Okay. Now we'll have to waste a couple of turns to wake up the eggs in the first place. I wonder how many turns it actually takes. Okay. Was that 4 or 5 turns? Sounds about right. And they're both plated, of course. Okay. Nice. We actually managed to stun this one, so it didn't even get to do anything. Oh, that's perfect. Such a nice, pleasant, almost danger-free ending to this. Okay, I'm not 100% sure. I checked every little corner and picked up every item on the ground that I might have seen. But I don't think I missed anything major. The queen herself didn't seem to drop anything. There is nothing to loot in here at all. Which does make sense. I mean, there were some crystals. And I guess they're... You know what? Might as well pick this up if I'm going to return to civilization. There was the corpse here with the very valuable plate mail. And if I hadn't already found one earlier or gotten one as a quest reward, I think, then that would have been a nice find. And, you know, obviously, I could have come here with 2 warriors or more. And obviously then another plated mail would be quite... Welcome. Oh, okay, I was wrong. Further south here than I thought. Ah, right, is this below the cave that I was thinking of? It is. Right. And the one west of here should be directly below Fort Renlon, actually. In fact, we might have confirmed as much. This has a barrier, I think, and we don't have another crystal yet. Let me just fix... quickly confirm that? Yes, okay. Of course, why else would I not have fully explored that? Alright, okay. Yes. This is... Wait, is this... Did I confirm it? I thought I'd found a letter leading up to Fort Renlon at some point, but I guess I have not. Maybe I'm thinking of something else. Right, we fought an Aranea in each of these rooms, and there is another single Aranea in this one. This is surprisingly harmless compared to what I've just been through. Wait, it's poor Helen. Okay. Speed potion. Can have another one. Let me guess. Well, look at that. A single Aranea in a large room. What do you know? Fireball. Wait. Arrow. Stab. If we can continue this pattern, I'm totally okay with that. For some reason, I thought there was another room directly opposite this one. I guess I didn't look right. Or else I would have known that that's not the case. Hello, Aranea. Okay, you're actually quite a bit closer, so there's a good chance that it's going to be able to attack Mike. Or maybe it's going to summon another spider. You know what? There, have some AoE damage. Almost killing the spider, okay. So that spider is not particularly high level, but I still missed it. Well, you're not gonna do anything here. Okay, thanks for, you know what? Yeah, please. I'm gonna return to some kind of town very soon, so not that worried about my mana. There is... not sure what? It's... Wurlikanen? Wurlikanen? That's some kind of boss spider, if I ever saw one. Wait there. Okay, thanks for coming here. Do I just attack it, or do I buff? I think I'm gonna attack it. Oh, it's resistant to magic. Okay. Protection. It's actually pretty resistant to everything, so I guess hasting would have been worthwhile. There. Haste him. Okay, you hasted yourself. But I think that will come too late. Because it should die now, unless something goes very, very wrong. There we go. Okay. And we get a silken shield. Oh, gymnastics and parry. Interesting. Parry is not going to help, but gymnastics might. Gymnastics being... harder to hit, helps you act faster. Okay. Well, he's the only one who already has some points in that skill. Poison resistance. I mean, I guess he'll get this one instead. This is 12 pounds. This is also 12 pounds. 8 armor, 10 armor. That being said, this is just an iron shield. And this is shield of warmth with some resistance. Well, I guess you'll get that then, and we drop the iron shield, which is just worse. Okay. And the back of this cave is covered with webs, arranged in delicate and intricate patterns. Looking closely, you realize that this is an Aranea spellbook. The spiders write about their magic in webs. Fortunately, the dialect they write in is not too far from a human variety, which is very surprising. You are able to decipher it, and you learn interesting things about the Aranea summoning arts. Your skill with the spell's minor summon and call beast increases. Dude, I love these multi-spell spellbooks. Even though this particular one is not really going to be of much use to me. Oh, hello. Hmm. Well, something tells me there is some sort of other way around. Also, this might not actually be directly below Fort Drennon, although the map says it is. Well, there is no direct way to... no, there is a direct way to the surface, never mind. Actually, this might be the one that I was thinking of, yeah. It's a little bit... that makes me a bit nervous that this gate actually did reclose itself at some point. Okay, this comes out here. I guess I had looked around here very briefly. No, never. Not really. I just came to the surface and headed back down immediately. That being said, Fort Renlon should be right over to the west. There is, of course, another Kytrak, and it's a plated one as well. God, I hate this place. This entire area. The entire western, eastern gallery. Gonna be quite happy once I'm done with this. Although the surface is probably not gonna be as bad as the underground section. Is this not Fort Renlon? No, I guess not. Wait, so this is above the... this is above the spider tunnel where it just was. Is it? I've already lost track. So, if that is true, there should be some sort of way down into that other part of the cave that I saw just a moment ago. Maybe past these traps. Oh. You know what? Not reloading because I'm don't think I'll be able to handle them, although, you know, once again, spell points, also all our buffs actually ran out again. And I'd rather just there we go. Just rest properly before heading out to the next dangerous expedition. But this definitely feels like something quest related, and I want to see if I can't pick up that quest first. Okay, good. So I was right. This is the map, and I guess this is might otherwise have we might otherwise have seen this tunnel from this side and wondered, there might be more to this map, but there is not, as far as we know, another access to this map. Also, I failed to look at this corner here, which is annoying me quite a bit. Whatever. Yeah, we probably wouldn't have found another way down anywhere on this entire on the entire map above this one. And you know, I don't know. I guess it's almost impossible though to miss absolutely all of those many, many other holes in the ground and all of those other maps east of here. So, oh wait, this is the other side of the river? Hold on a second. No way. So we weren't east of Fort Renom, but north of it, I guess, even though the map doesn't properly display the proportions here. Some herbs. Some more herbs. Several dig spots. Wide open swampland. Rabbit rat that doesn't care about us. Another digging spot. You're at the edge of Slitzerica lands. The border has been clearly marked with statues and totems with skulls. Some of the skulls are human. You can see a victorious creature sitting around smoke. What? You can see the victorious creatures sitting around smoking campfires to the northwest. Some of them look well armed, and the creatures seem stronger the farther north you look. Care would probably be wise. If Fort Renlon hasn't sent raiders here yet, they must be well defended. Yeah. Presumably. I'm still gonna pick this up. Not seeing the slits yet. Grey mold. Oh, grey mold. Might have been worth taking a little bit of a risk for. Okay. Well, good to know that we can, in theory, foray into Slithlands if we want to or have to for some reason. So that is, yeah, that's this corner. It doesn't look like it's connected to anything, but that doesn't necessarily mean anything. This is around the area that had the Slith Temple, I think? Or that might have been down here. No, I think this might have had the or a large Slith Temple in the previous games. Of course, things may have changed quite a bit, as they have elsewhere. Alright, so this tunnel is really just to get to the Slithlands. And then we have the outpost of Slith. I don't know if it's a Slith scout party, basically, or some kind of Slith rebels or something. Oh, not enough nature lore. Huh, that's slightly annoying. I guess Overworld, north of Drenlon. Dig. Right. Well, let's finish checking this place. Okay, there was more grey mold. Ah, and this must be adrenaline, of course. Pick this up real quick. What's this? Play the kite rack. Don't know why I didn't shoot. Just want to check this out, and it's just a stick. I don't know why it looked so strange. Yeah, no idea. It's a perfectly normal stick. Okay, that's this map accounted for, apart from that Slith camp. And I know there is going to be more Hydrex around, but I think we should be able to map out this place, maybe. Minus any potentially more involved caves up here. Oh, this is just a very elaborate, very long and winding dead end filled with trash, but there is a wall there, constructed wall. Rogues, huh? What are you called? Skunky Joe? Okay, this is Skunky Joe's hideout. Keep out. Okay. Skunky Joe is hanging out outside his own hideout. Did they all just turn hostile? Were they not hostile before? No, they were not. Okay. It does say keep out. I guess I'm gonna stay away from them for now and see if anyone in Fort Renlon maybe wants me to deal with them officially. Or possibly deal with them in a non-hostile way, even though I very much doubt it. Is this part of the hideout as well? No, apparently not, but it's also empty, so I guess it doesn't matter. Wait, did we? Yes. We did check out this entire map. Right, this is where I first went down into this, into the horrible nightmare of a place. Okay, actually I had completely forgotten about this stash here, so good thing I just happened to walk by. And now of course, oh, I did not even mean to click on that because I didn't see it. Oh wow, there is so much to dig here.
What?
All kinds of crystals, and of course, yes, we were going to run into another kite rack sooner or later. Now that Dirk is once again completely useless. These things, and there are many, many action points. It's never gonna fail to amaze me how much they can do. Heal. Heal. What? No. Wrong button. Save the game. Keep digging. Beautiful crystal. Wonderful. Flawed. Flawed. You know, I don't even discriminate. I take them all. I love all the crystals. This box contains dirty clothes, some moldy bread, and a large rusty saw. Oh, that seems familiar. Yeah, we've seen something similar. These words are etched on its handle. Rob saw, do not touch. You take it with you? Again. So we have taken it, his axe, I think, and his saw. If Grob was so attached to it, perhaps it's valuable. Yeah, or perhaps, I don't know. Why are we doing this? Seems very unwise. I'm not saying I wouldn't have taken the things. In fact, I most likely would have if the game had given me a chance. But still, it doesn't feel quite right that it just forces that decision on you. Feels out of character, I think. Because it doesn't usually do that. But oh well. Alright, that's actually another map accounted for. And pretty sure that, yeah, we've never been south of here, so except for these two spots where we quickly briefly surfaced. Alright, let's actually take a look at Fort Renlon. Just a very, very quick look, because the episode is about to end. Oh, actually, Fort Renlon is tiny. That's the first time a map doesn't cover basically an entire map. Some sort of town or settlement, I mean, doesn't cover the entire map. Okay, so I guess we're not actually going to enter Fort Renlon, but I'm gonna map out the rest of this map as far as I can reach. Probably not gonna be able to go to the other side of this river. Herbs, actually, yeah, you've been picking up a bunch of herbs, I think. Or maybe not? I guess we picked up more gray mold at some point. How encumbered is she from all the herbs? Almost encumbered. We'll have to drop some of those off at my storage place of choice. Oh, enemies. Great. Swamp Goblin. Also great. Okay, good. Not that worried about the Swamp Goblin, honestly. Maybe I should, who knows? Maybe they're really bad. It's not doing anything. I mean, it's hostile though, so it's only a matter of time before it will do something. Okay. Oh, wait. Mike literally cannot do anything, but okay. Whatever. Swamp Goblin, not very smart, as it turns out. No big surprise there, I guess. Oh. Swamp Nodule. Wow, they are just lying around like that. Huh. Well, since I... Okay, there's another one there. Since I did notice that one immediately, there's also a digging spot. I guess I probably didn't miss any others. Maybe. I'm gonna take another careful look at this particular swampy area. Yeah. That's 3 out of, I think, 7 or 8. According to my list. Okay, healing herbs. Yeah, I don't see any more in the areas I've already checked. Yes, I did see that Kydrek, but I decided that I'd wait and see if it saw me, and I guess that's probably the same one from before. Okay. Well, right, this is still that map. Okay, and I'm gonna wait right outside the gates of Fort Renlon, and we'll have the proper introduction to this tiny, tiny little outpost. We'll see what kinds of facilities there even are. It does have its own teleport pylon, I guess. And I'm assuming that it's probably also going to heal me. Maybe it doesn't have the full assortment of facilities that I expect, but so long as it has a shop, I guess I'm okay. And hopefully it will have a bunch of quests to do with, you know, killing the Kytrak Queen and the bandits we saw up there, and also maybe those sliths. Those 3 things would be nice. I mean, if I don't get any quests for them, I guess I'm gonna check them out just on my own, just because they're there, as usual. But, you know, a quest would be nice. Anyway, that being said, I'm gonna call it an episode here. We're finally done, mostly done with the tunnels. We still have, right, Reptile Island. Almost forgot about that one. So we know that the network of tunnels does connect down there, does connect over to the island. I mean, I'm fully expecting, of course, to find a way to the surface so we can explore the island itself instead of just the underground area. But I would be very surprised if that were not the case. Anyway, yeah, also, look at the map. I mean, we're right outside Fort Renlon. Yeah, so correlation is not always that, doesn't always work that well, but, you know, that's fine. As I said, as I was already beginning to say minutes ago, as always, I thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment, and I shall see you real soon. Bye-bye.